So guys, I joined PFRDA, Pension Fund Regulatory and Development Authority, which is one of the financial regulators of India, back in August 2017. And now I have left PFRDA and I am pursuing PGP, that is Postgraduate Program in Management from Indian School of Business, ISB. That is a 1 year full-time MBA program. And I've left my job, which is a government job, a very well-paying job, and I am from Delhi and I was posted in Delhi and the office is in Delhi, going to remain in Delhi. I'm married, my wife is also working in Delhi. So essentially I have left a well-paying, stable government job. Now why would I do that and go for higher studies? So I want to talk about, so any situation will have two factors, push factors and pull factors. So I'll talk about the push factors first, the factors that pushed me to leave this job and go study. So when I quit my first job, that was in private sector, I quit that to pursue civil services. I wanted to become an IAS, IPS officer. And the notion at that point of time was that I'll get power and I'll use this power to create a huge impact in the society, economy, and in people's lives. So now this thing is known as need for power in motivation theory in psychology. So I was driven by a need for power. Now, PFRDA is a financial regulator. Even if it is a small regulator, the regulators always have some power in their industries that they regulate. So I was essentially a part of that powerful organization. Individual power may not be there, but at least I was there in the decision-making process. So when I felt that power, that our decisions, our way of thinking, our communications are actually powerful, they have the potential to create impact in some industry or in some companies, let's say, it felt good in the start, but very quickly it lost its appeal. And I started realizing that probably I am more, I want a sense of achievement, which is known as need for achievement motivation in motivation theory. So in these years, I have understood myself in a better way. I'm still, understanding myself, and I've come to a growing realization that I'm more driven by a need for achievement rather than the need for power. So while impact, I have to see impact on a big level to feel that I've achieved something. And this critical component was missing in my job. And I have been one of the lucky ones who got to work in different departments. So I worked in three four areas. So I'm lucky in that sense. It's a small organization and you get to know everyone else. You make good relationships, you talk to other people. So I developed a pretty good idea about the organization, how it's structured, how it works. So I also started realizing that that probably PFRDA is not going to be that impactful as I wish, because Parliament had its own intent while creating PFRDA, and even the Act is still with the Parliament of India. So probably the government, the parliament, is trying to figure out the way forward for PFRDA and NPS trust and NPS as a system. So probably there is going to be some redefinition and revisiting your goals. So I felt that, you know, it's probably going to take a lot more time before PFRDA as a regulator, as a body, establishes itself. I spent almost 4 years here, and I also realized that I am not that patient. I mean, when I quit my private sector job, when I was preparing for civil services, I knew that government service or public sector service does not come with, high growth, comes with rotations, transfers, and you may be stuck with people you don't want to work with. I knew all of that, but at that point of time, all these negatives or disadvantages did not seem to be too bothersome to me, and all the pros and benefits outweighed these disadvantages. But having spent 4 years, and 1 year before that, before PFRDA, I was working with GIC Re, which is another public sector insurance company. So having spent 5 years in public sector and regulatory domain, I as I discovered myself more, I understood that I want growth in my career as well, in my professional life as well, and that kind of stagnation, you can say, started weighing down on me. And let me be clear, PFRD is one of the government or public sector organizations that has really good promotion policy and growth opportunity in terms of promotions, because PFRD is a lean organization, unlike RBI, where it's very hard to get promoted. But still, I mean, 4 years, after 4 years, I was not actually leading any team. I was working in an individual contributor role. And then, as much as I would like to believe that I don't believe in comparison and all that, I did start comparing myself with my peers from my engineering days, who have been like 8 years in the industry now. Many have done their MBAs, many have gone abroad, and I started comparing my life, and some people who have already cleared civil services, so I started comparing my career, my role, my life, my direction with my peers, and I started feeling that probably I can do better, I can still do better, with my career and my future. So, I thought of it from a long-term perspective, I thought that I might not really enjoy the next 30 years in this organization, in this role, in any of the roles in this industry, So, I thought that my excitement towards my work started diminishing. And more importantly, my will to learn and upskill myself also started diminishing, and probably one of the reasons is the maybe lack of incentives towards learning or upskilling. So I started feeling complacent and comfortable in my life, and that's the point when I felt that I don't want to live this life for the next 20-30 years. That's when I decided to, these are the factors that pushed me. Now what attracted me is the MBA. Now why MBA? I did explore other exit options. One was pursuing CFA or FRM, these professional qualifications which are part-time. And then try to switch to the industry side of things, but that would have taken a lot of time and would still not have may not have intended effects, so to say. So I researched, I talked to my friends, and I figured that an MBA is the most practical option for me that gives that would give me all these benefits under one roof in a single program. So I'll get to learn a mix of different subjects, including finance, investments, risk, marketing strategy, you know, HR, etc., etc. And since it will be a full-time program, it will add credibility to my profile, and it will also help me with placements because it will be a full-time program. Plus, the network of alumni that you get, network of peers that you get, you know, you develop friendships, that really goes long term. And the kind of flexibility that the program provides in terms of career choices. So that's why all these, you know, all these good things about an MBA program pulled me towards it. And that's why I decided to go for an MBA. So that pretty much sums it. Why I didn't go for an online MBA or distance MBA is because, you know, these programs don't really help you in changing your job or even industry because they are not that credible. Why I did not go into public policy is because I did not want to move abroad. And in India, there are very few schools that are good for public policy. And I think the job scenario is also evolving right now. And frankly, I wanted to move towards the business side of things to understand, you know, some industries in a better way. And again, an MBA will also provide me an option to move towards public policy. Whereas a public policy degree will not provide an option to move to, you know, business side of things. So that's why I think the MBA was the most logical option for me. So yeah, thank you.